Hey guys, it's Allie here. This is my first YouTube tutorial video, so we'll see how this goes. I don't usually have this much time on my hands, but I really want to do this. What I really wanted to do is make a video kind of showing my process for breaking in, sewing, all of that, my pointe shoes, because I've had a lot of people ask about that. Of course, this is like the one time I don't have a brand new pair of shoes that I actually normally wear. Ready to break in and everything, because I've kind of already done that with all of them. So the pair that I'm going to do today is a pair of Freeds. I have not, even these are a custom pair that I had made trying to see if I could make Freeds work for me. And they just aren't working for me. So that's what I'm going to do today. So with the Freeds, I also have to darn them because that's the only way I can really feel where the box is and keep myself balanced and stable and not sigiling on Freeds. For whatever reason, I just have to with those. Those are the only shoes I ever darn are Freeds. I normally wear a couple different shoes. Normally I wear a gainer midden. So these are these? They're a 3 box, which is much more tapered than the 4, which took me a long time to be okay with because the 4s are very supportive and stable, but they're just too wide for my feet. So I was wearing these giant jelly toe pads trying to make it work. And while it made point work so much easier, I was really cheating my technique because of all the room in my shoes and everything, and I was really sinking and it started to hurt my toes. So I gave in, had to go to the 3s, which are much more tapered, but it just works better for me. I also am wearing the Feather Shank, which is the blue. It's the second lightest because I just don't have a good natural arch. It's much better than it used to be, but it's still not a great arch. So wearing the Feather Shank helps me get over much easier and is much more supportive for me. I can wear the Supple, the pink one, but the blue I've found is much better, especially with this tapered box. The blue works better for me. And gainers allow me to order a lower vamp, which is awesome because I really need that because I have really short toes. And just because of where my foot arches, like a shorter vamp just works better for me. These happen to be a Cincinnati ballet dancer, which is really awesome, has been selling hers on eBay because she, I guess, changed shoe sizes, whatever. She has tons of them. So this is like the 3rd or 4th pair I bought from her supply on eBay, which is awesome because they're already in my size. I don't have to wait for Gainer Midden to make them, which takes forever. So I'm kind of hoping that that supply keeps going because I want to keep buying them from her because they're really awesome and they just look cool. And like, this is a brand new pair. And I don't know, they look so pretty on the back. So that's one pair that I wear. Another pair, so shockingly, I always said Block don't work for me until I tried Block Heritage. So this is the only Block shoe that works for me. It has a lower vamp with the V-cut in it, so it helps my feet to get over, even though like just every other shoe, like Grishko's, Freed's, they all make a very high vamp, and that just does not work for me. So these have a lower vamp. They have kind of the Russian make, which I love my Russian shoes. And I do 3/4 all of my shoes, so they're all cut out like this. And then on these blocks too, this is the first time I've ever done this, and I've noticed it's helped a ton. Someone taught me to shave down kind of the outside here, because it makes the shoe lay more flat. Which is really helping because, like, you know, just standing flat, even like to do a promenade, things like that, I was wobbling a ton and it was bothering me. And sometimes it kind of hurts my feet a little bit, so I may do it with the heel eventually too because the heel really hurts kind of there. But yeah, these are the like only pair of Block shoes that work for me. So these, the gainers, and then obviously my favorite, I'm actually wearing a pair of them right now, are the Russian points. So let's see, where are the right ones? So I do wear both the Encore and the Ruben. So these are a pair of my Encores with a really short vamp, very beat up. And these are a pair of my Rubens, again, very short vamp because I ordered shorter vamp, but you can tell the difference because the backs are very different. The Ruben, the Jewels collection is kind of a sewn one, and then the Encore, the Spotlight collection is not sewn, so it's much easier to 3/4, which is why I've switched to the Encore because I 3/4 all my shoes, like I said. So with a brand new pair of shoes, I've kind of already done this a little bit with the Freeds. Let's get to that now. So here are the lovely pair of custom Freeds that I have yet to do anything with. Very pretty, very pretty. I just love how they look. I love that they're made in London because I used to live in England and I kind of miss it. I have here 2 other pairs. So on these other pairs, you can see that I have cut off the tips and darned them, which took a lot of work, but that's what I did with them. Same with this pair, cut off the tips and darned them. So they lay much flatter. These two I will probably scrape down the sides because I'm learning that with Freed's that needs to happen too. So when I first get a pair, these came much flatter than this. My first thing that I do is I flatten the top of the box. So I will kind of, I'll either do this with my palms, you know, flatten it out a little bit, or I like to step on it with my heel. So I do that. I also bend the shank like where my arch is. So I will bend it. I have not three-quartered these. So I'm kind of debating if I'm going to or not. I think I probably will have to. And I probably should do that for this video to help you guys. So that's generally where I start. So now you can see it has a nice bend to it. Then I take water and I kind of go around this part right here where my demi point is and like right around here and just get it a little bit wet just to kind of soften the paste up on the sides to kind of help the shoe be more mobile for me because braids are really hard when they come, like really hard. And the shanks are really hard. Like this is a soft shank and it's really hard. So let me bend my other one here. Okay, nice bend. I also tie my drawstrings, which I already did. So let me go grab my tools. I'm gonna show you guys what I kind of have out here. This is gonna be fun. So I've got obviously the shoes right here. These are very strong scissors for cutting off my shank. This kind of helps me get off part of the shank and shave down the sides here. This helps me kind of get the satin off the tip of the shoe. And I've got elastics, ribbon, sewing kit, and my darning tools, which is a straight thick thread, some thick thread, a straight thick needle, and a thimble to protect my fingers. So I'm going to, for three-quartering, peel back, which this actually came back pretty easily. Oh, I forgot my little pliers because I'm gonna need to pull. There's a little nail in here. So you'll see after I pull back, there is a little nail right here that we're gonna be pulling out. And then this, actually this is very bendable shank today. Maybe we won't three-quarter it after all, actually. This is a very bendy shank. I'm just gonna pull it apart to help it a little bit and maybe pull the nail out anyway. If you are not darning the shoe, but you're just gonna take the satin off the tip of the shoe to kind of give you some more traction or whatever it be, you do need to make sure that you use a lighter to kind of go around the edges just like you would for your ribbons so that it doesn't start to fray. Because I think the fact that I darn them makes it not fray, but if you don't, it probably will, and that'll just help your shoes last longer. The darning does help them last longer because you've got the fabric there. So now we're gonna sew. First, I'm just gonna do the elastic and ribbons. So these are actually old elastics that I took off other shoes because I don't have any elastics because I need to buy some more. So let's see here. So I got a stitch kit already. This stitch kit by Bunheads is fantastic. Like the thickness of the thread and the needles is perfect. I've gotten other stitch kits where they kind of suck, and this is really good. So that's the elastics. I usually do the loop elastics. Sometimes I do the cross elastics, but it just takes so much more effort and more elastic that I just don't have today, so that's why I'm doing the loop. I like to do it on the outside because then if the shoes are tight, it doesn't hurt me as much in like plie, things like that. Somehow I also just think it looks kind of nicer on the outside. I like being able to see it on the outside. Some people don't, so you can do it either way, but I do it right on the back of the seam there. So for ribbons, there's a couple different ways that I've done it, and I kind of haven't figured out my way yet. So got my ribbon, and I will start by cutting it in halves. So you can either do cut it in fourths, and you know, you sew it to each side. I kind of like doing it just in half, and I think I did this on a pair already up here. I cut it in half, just the whole thing in half, and then I just sewed across. So, and I sewed it right on my arch so that it kind of helps pull my arch up in the shoe, as opposed to like this pair is sewn all like that, so it's much more open. I kind of like it with it pulling up my arch because, like I said, I don't have a great arch naturally, so I have to use what I can. So that's helpful for me. So let's see here. I'm just gonna do the two today because obviously that's even quicker for me too to sew. I will eventually make a video on how to 3/4 shanks when I get a new pair of like Russians that I have to do. Since these actually I think might work without it, I'm gonna test them like that first. If I have to, I can always still 3/4 them, but I kind of prefer not to if I don't have to. So, two pieces of ribbon. Here we go. So once I have sewn, got my elastic, got my ribbon, the next thing I need to do is cut the ribbons where I want to tie them, because generally I tie them a little, most people do I think on the inside here. You don't want to tie them on the back on your Achilles, that's really bad. And on the front looks really dumb, and on this other side looks, you want to tie them on like this inside ankle bone here. So I have to cut them where I want them, and then we use a lighter to kind of keep the ends from fraying. So. In my point shoes, so generally in Russians are the only ones I really use these in, but I love these little gel pillows things. They're fantastic because Russian boxes are fairly hard on my toes, but once those are in, everything's fine. But then my absolute favorite are these perfect fit point toe pads. So they're gel molded for my toes. I actually just ordered another pair because these are getting really bad and I've had these for well over a year. So these are my favorites. They give me just enough cushioning because I have kind of sensitive feet, but not too much that I can't feel the floor. So, which is also why I darn too. So right now what we're gonna do is check and see where I need to cut my ribbons. So this next part is a little different. I only do this on Freed's. I don't do it on any of their shoes because these are the only shoes I feel like I need to. The tips of the shoes just don't always feel flat to me, and I want them to feel very flat and everything. So what I do is darn them. I already snipped off the satin on the bottoms here, so you can see this is just the canvas underneath. So what I'll use is, and everybody uses different stuff. This is just what I got because I was at the craft store when I wanted to start doing this. So I have a thimble to protect my fingers because you have to go through the box of the shoe, which is really hard to do. I have a very thick straight needle and then a thicker like craft thread that I use that's similar to the color of the point shoe. Some people use big yarn. I don't. I've also seen many ways to do this where you can wrap like sections of this around and then start doing the stitches for the darning. I like to just do just the darning stitches, so that's actually all I've done on these. I've just done multiple layers of them. I don't know how well you can see those, but I've just done multiple layers. So here you do have to go kind of up through the shoe fabric, which is why you're gonna need your thimble. And then you just gotta get it through as much of the fabric there as you can, and then push it through with the thimble, and then I like to make a loop with it after that, so I'll just keep darning here. So here is one shoe done. I'm not gonna film me doing the other shoe, but I will go ahead and do it. So yep, this is what they look like together. One shoe is done. And I may put a little more stitches around this one, make it a little more even, but I don't need to film that. All right, so finally done with both shoes. So another tip I learned for doing darning from a professional, I don't remember who it was, is that to help kind of get your correct alignment so that you're not sickling, is to put more string on where your pinky toe is gonna be. So since this is my right shoe, I put more darning on the outside, so it kind of helps me tilt my feet so that I'm not sickling. Same with on this one, I put more on this side over here, so to kind of give my feet a little push. I also remembered from doing this that I really hate darning shoes. My hands are so tired now. So if you don't have to, great. And honestly, unless I'm wearing Freed's, I don't have to. So the next thing we're gonna do is I'm going to take my little knife here and we're gonna scrape off some of the outer portion here to make it a little flatter so that it feels more comfortable to stand on. So here we go. So now you can see, I kinda took the edges down a little bit on the sides. So these are done. That took a really long time. My Russians never take this long. Blocks don't take much effort and gainers take none. I just sew them and they're good to go. Freed's just take a lot more effort, but I figured this is helpful for some people. I still may take out like 3/4 of the shank if I decide that these are still not working for me. We'll see. The other thing I do sometimes with Freed's, these are custom so I shouldn't have to, but I still don't feel like they made the vamp low enough, is so they do have a little seam there. I still may cut along that seam and make my own vamp shorter. I've done that on my other two pairs here, so these are two different shoes that I've cut the vamp lower on because I just need it. So we'll see. Hope that helped. If you have any questions, just let me know.